packed with gore, and a whole lot more. Here's your look at the super action stuff, Casket of Cruelty action figure accessories. Create your very own bloodbath with the Casket of Cruelty action figure accessories. The set includes 30 accessories in half scale for 6 to 7 inch scale figures, includes a full size half scale casket, an armory of post apocalyptic weapons, and plenty of blood action effects. Maybe, before we get down to the decapitated details of the Casket of Cruelty, let's grab the tape measure and see how tall the actual casket stands. The Happycat Industries Super Action Stuff Casket of Cruelty is available through various online sites. I just happen to have ordered this over on Entertainment Earth, and the asking price was about $35. For $35, you're getting at least a plastic casket that has removable lid, not to mention all, again, the gory details of all the other things that come included with it as well. From a standpoint of the casket, it actually stands at 7 1/4 inches in height, or it's going to be about 18 centimeters tall. While I may have been initially reeled into the concept of having gory effects attached onto my figures, one good thing at least about the set is that it includes a plastic casket. The casket itself is made of decent enough plastic. It's nicely printed there as well to kind of give you the look that it's made of wood, and it does have a removable lid. One thing unfortunately was dashed right away because I had big plans for this. Not necessarily for Dracula, but for this killer of Camp Crystal Lake. I was hoping at the very least I'd be able to store Jason inside, and while most figures fit, Jason unfortunately does not. I have to kind of really rub the top of his head to fit him inside the casket. I suppose if you wanted to, you could have Jason somewhat kind of sitting up from the casket. And again, at least that it's plastic, I feel like already I'm getting some value out of this. Bringing in some other figures as well for comparison's sake. Let's bring in the deceased Supergirl. Deceased Supergirl fits in fine. I mean, again, she's a good size. I feel like if you're getting figures and around this size, they should fit in fine the casket. Here's the ultimate, for example, Evil Dead Bruce Campbell, or Ash, obviously. And he sits, again, already inside, but he's clearly also shorter than Jason Voorhees. So he's not, you know, he's going to clear it at least inside. Not that you necessarily would want to display Ash Williams inside of a casket. I'm sure he's not going to enjoy that at all. So at least the casket is good, although I do honestly wish it was a little bit longer to accommodate figures like, say, a Jason Voorhees. And, you know, again, like part 4 is not maybe the best Jason as an example. Part 6 would probably be the better example. But even then, any figure after this size right here is already not going to fit. The casket, I feel, should have maybe just been a little bit longer, but really the idea in mind is that they all accommodate 6 to 7 inch scale figures. Of the other things that come included with this, okay, again, you got some weapons, you got some gore effects as well. Some of the things that were involving some assembly is that you get yourself a crossbow. The crossbow basically comes in two parts. By the way, there are no instructions at all with the Casket of Cruelty. And also, you may have noticed at the beginning of this review as well that there was all this additional, I don't want to say unnecessary packing paper all shredded inside. I'm fine for that, but with having some of the pieces, like the eyeballs, did you just say eyeballs? With some of the eyeballs, like for example, being the smallest of the accessories, I was really worried that as I was pulling out all this confetti, that some of the smaller parts may ultimately have been thrown in recycling. I had to kind of fish through everything. So I think while I'm fine with the idea that they would have had everything with packing paper, packing shredded paper, I think really then all the accessories should have also been packed inside baggies, just to ensure that you're not going to be throwing anything out in the process. But you get basically two halves of the crossbow. You get the main, of course, I guess the part that actually stretches back. That all you do is basically there's a little tab opening here, and then you just fit this over the front frame of this, and it snaps in place. Got yourself a little crossbow. Along with that, though, you also get yourself a couple of arrows. You get two variations of arrow. One is still pretty clean. It has yet been used. The other one, as you can see, has been broken off with already the start of what will be a whole bloody adventure. You can see there's a little bit of dripping blood down below here. The way they've handled the blood is actually nice. It sort of has, I guess, like a gelatin look to it. It's like translucent, a very bright red. And again, like you have two different arrows that you can display. The set also comes included with a nail gun. I will admit, though, while the set has sort of questionable choices for what they, like the SWAT shield, for example, I would never end up finding myself a way of displaying that. Now, just because I don't plan to display them ever with the SWAT shields for any one of my figures, doesn't mean, though, it's not a welcomed accessory to come included with this. Thing that I would be more interested in, for example, is like a nail gun. That looks good. Granted, there is no nails that come out to the... I mean, if they had included, say, for example, a couple of firing nail pieces that could have projected out the front of it, that would have been nice. But you can at least get yourself a nail gun. From a handle standpoint, let's go back and grab Ash here, only just because he's one of the figures that have a gripping hand. And the grips for some of these aren't so bad. Like, for example, if you want to take, like, the nail gun, It fits okay in his hand, providing I had to like kind of stretch the plastic just a little bit, but he holds it okay. Maybe he was going all about this the wrong way. Instead of wielding a chainsaw, maybe, hey, he should have had a nail gun instead. But the nail gun, again, nicely detailed. That's one of the better looking accessories, I have to admit, that come included with this. Things that I'm not as, you know, honestly interested in is like the cricket bat. A cricket bat, first of all, I feel is way too thick. It is a little deformed on the end. You can see there's quite a bit of blood all saturated on the front of it. The way they've actually got these little indentations, it looks a little bit like Swiss cheese. A big block of swinging Swiss cheese. Whoosh, whoosh. It's okay, but again, like, I have real no plans for this. But just because, again, like, I have no interest in it doesn't mean that it's not a worthy accessory. It does also come included with a samurai sword, a katana, if you will. Wakizashi, also. I think for the length of blade, obviously, I think probably would say it's more of a katana. And there's also a swooshing effect. There's a canal right here, right through here, that you just take the end of the sword and just guide it all the way through. And then you got yourself a little swoosh effect. Whoosh, whoosh. Don't swing that too far. Because honestly, though, the little swing effects or all the little blood pieces that attach onto the blades, they don't stay on super securely. You can see they're using some translucent plastic for this case. But it does look good. Just don't be careful. Don't swing it too far because it's going to come off very easily. There's also, again, a few little blood effects that also have sort of the same idea. You just slide these onto the ends of the blades. And some work a little bit better than others. So, like, for example, you want to have this one. There's also a slightly smaller version of that, which this one honestly doesn't fit as well, which I think it more so belongs with some of the other accessories instead. But all basically work the exact same way. You also get yourself a machete, which I just happen to have Jason wielding from, what, the 2009 remake of Friday the 13th. He was carrying that around at the beginning of this review. You can already see he's been busy. There's a bit of blood there on the bottom there. And again, like, if you wanted to, you could take the same effect that we looked at from before that just attaches on the end of it. You could attach it that way. You could attach it this way if I suppose it was swinging this way. But either way, it attaches just onto the end of the blade. Looks good. Nice little, again, translucency of the red there. That's a healthy blood, I believe. Also to come included with this, while we're still sticking with weapons, comes included with the chainsaw. Now, the chainsaw I did have at the beginning in the hands of Ash, again, the handles are fairly thick, but he still was able to accommodate it. Again, it just fits into his hand like that. There is also, again, like, if you want to use the little clip-on pieces, that works also as well with the chainsaw. The thing that's also neat about this is that the chainsaw piece actually comes in two parts. When you get it out of the packaging, it comes in this piece and it comes in this piece. The reasoning why it's separate like this is that there's also this buzzsaw blade, and that just fits on the end of it. Would that be a jigsaw blade? That's a pretty devastating blade either way. Again, it looks like it's been quite generously used. There's a bit of blood there on the end of it. I say bits. I mean, like, that's exaggerating. Look at the amount of blood. That's all across the blade. And that all is just a case of just detaching it. So, again, it just comes off like this. And there's a little square peg hole there that just accommodates the square peg on the other side. Just plugs in like that. So, again, you can either have it displayed like the buzzsaw blade, or if you want, you can also go back and revert back to the chainsaw blade. So we'll just put those off to the side as well. Again, kind of into the more territory of the things I'm less interested in. You got yourself a pair of boxing gloves. These would just fit over, like, well, do we have a figure right now to work with? Let's just go back. I mean, Ash has a stump anyways. If you wanted to, it wouldn't work as really well with Ash. You really would want to really remove the hands, for example, and then the boxing glove would fit over top of that. Can I do that with Ash? Let's see if I can carefully remove the hands. There we go. For a second, I thought I broke it. Then I realized the peg's on the end. It's on the end of his forearm. So, like, if you wanted to, just take the boxing glove, fits it over his hand. I mean, maybe not the best idea for, you know, sparring, even though I just dropped it. Sparring maybe with deadites. Maybe that's the best idea that he's had. But it does fit over top of the existing forearms of most figures. Let's put the hand back on before I lose it. So, there we go. And one of the other things that comes included in the category of less interested, get yourself a nightstick. It's a pretty chunky nightstick. May not work necessarily as well with, like, Ash. May not work either with, like, a Jason Voorhees. But, hey, why not? If you wanted to, display with a Marvel Legends figure. 6 to 7 inch scale. That's basically within the scale that we're working with. It may not work with, like, for example, if you had, like, a Judge Dredd of the Hiya Toys variety, way too small. If you had, like a 6 scale, 12 inch tall figure, it's not going to work either with that. It's kind of like you really want to stick with 6 to 7 inches. The set also comes included with an axe, which I think the axe is pretty decent. It's looking like it's cast here in all gold plastic. The blade itself, ooh, be careful I don't draw my own blood. The blade itself has been done here in silver with a little bit of airbrushing of a darker color added in there as well. And again, like, the handles are all pretty much the same size. So if you find yourself a figure that can accommodate, like, the cricket bat, then you're pretty much going to find the same size scale of figure that's also going to be able to wield around an axe. Also get yourself a riot shield. Not all that interested, really, with the idea of Riot Shield for me. Now, they've done actually a couple of sets of these. If you did want to check out more, by the way, you can go to www.superactionstuff.com. But they've actually done a couple of different, not casket sets, but different add-on accessories for action figures. I feel like there's one that actually has, like, bullet-firing effects that go on the end of the guns. I feel like a Riot Shield may belong more to the category of that and less to the category of Casket of Cruelty. I just don't feel like this really rightfully belongs in a set that's majority more just, like, weapons to inflict damage on others. I just don't feel like the Riot Shield belongs in that space. What I do feel like belongs in this space is, again, all these additional blood effects. Depending on how you really are, whether you're a talented figure photographer, for example, or you just like to have really gory-looking diorama sets, you get all these cool little blood effects. Now, the opener of this review, jokingly, I sort of did use myself ET for this. This is basically like if somebody was vomiting blood. That's quite gruesome. ET was basically one I just used just because he was a good size for that without having to get them down on their knees. Literally, I mean, well, it doesn't really line up necessarily to their face. You just basically put it pretty close to ET's face so it looks like he's barfing up blood. That's lovely. You get also a couple of additional fun things, like, for example, a dripping heart. I'm guessing this to be a heart. There's a peg right here that I don't think belongs to anything. One of the things, too, as I may have already mentioned, if I didn't already mention, I'll mention it now, there's no instructions at all. So you really have to just use your imagination and guess to where these things are supposed to go. You get yourself a dripping heart, for example, nicely painted. I did decide, I think, to use this at the beginning of the review with using Predator. Yeah, that's right. I had the Predator holding the heart in his hand. I think it made the most sense. Obviously, again, you could use it with any one of your figures. Again, you got that translucency of the red of the blood down below. A nicely painted heart there on the top as well. It almost looks as if this is supposed to be held, like this is supposed to grip in someone's hand. I've tried to do that, again, with the only example I was having at the time with Ash, but it doesn't really look like it belongs. Like it doesn't look like it's supposed to clip on the end, and yet it looks like it's supposed to. There's also as well a brain. Brains. Which I did have in the hand of the deceased Supergirl, but again, you could use it for whatever really you want. You can also, too, double up these things, too, as well. So if you wanted to add, like, the blood effect onto the bottom of the brain, for example, like this is blown out the back of someone's head, you could do that as well. You get all these effects, and one of the smallest things, which, again, goes back to the whole idea, like, why would they have used packing paper to store these things? Literally, like, if you open up the casket, all these things are loose inside. These things, like eyeballs, for example, should have really been carefully packed inside of bags. Get two eyeballs. I mean, normal people, for the most part, have two eyeballs. I don't think I've met anyone that has three eyeballs. But you get two of these. I actually had them in between the fingers of Supergirl because I thought that just worked well. If you did also, and we're going to talk a little bit more about this in a moment, if you had like Mac Tack, sticky tack, you could also stick this in the sockets of an eyeball of like a zombie, for example. I think I used the beginning of Bubba. And you could just put a little bit of Mac Tack in the eyeballs. Let's just actually know where he is. He's right over here. Bringing in him in, if you had some sticky tack, you could really put then the eyeballs into that. I mean, there's no other way really to attach any of these effect pieces. You have to then use some sticky tack. One of the things, too, that they also advertise is that they sell standalone wax, like a little adhesive wax that you just basically put on the figure where you want to put these effects, and then you would just stick the pieces onto them. They're not permanent. You don't have to commit to the idea. If you change your mind down the road, you want to move those things somewhere else, you can. I feel like almost, if anything, they should have upsold, just including a little bit of wax. Give the collectors, give the customers a chance to kind of experience what that wax would be like. And then from there, you know, they could always purchase more down the road. But I feel like some wax should have really been included because all the other things that we're going to be looking at really then involve having to use sticky tack that you're going to have to purchase on your own. So you get all these, like I said, we keep going back to these. We get these blast effects. You get two of these, and this is basically the exit wounds, quite seriously damaging exit wounds. These would basically attach onto figures' bodies. Strangely, though, that this one has more like a recessed hole, almost as if it belongs on either someone's on the top of their head or the end of their forearm. Other than that, I can't really understand why they would put such a hole like this on the bottom of it. In both cases, though, this one's a little bit more flat. But they're actually molded again in that, again, kind of gelatinous red translucent plastic. One thing I really like, not that one looks like a face, but they've got these little chunks of skin and flesh and all the things that would be blasted out of your body if you ever got hit by something. I think that's a nice little touch. You also get as well a few of the more little small splattered pieces. You also get, well, again, like variations of that. So they're just of different shapes. They're kind of like gorier versions of the butt of snowflakes. Just the fact that each one of them look different from one another. That's really, that's kind of dark, isn't it? A little dark. So you get these, and then you also get a few exit wound explosions as well. So basically, if someone's being shot, you also get a slightly smaller version of that. Basically, all of this can only be accomplished if you have yourself some sticky tack. I have myself, and I've been kind of using this off and on throughout the series of my reviews. I've got this on over on Amazon, and basically all it is like it comes in a roll like this, although it's kind of picked up some of the plastics and styrofoam all around my floor here. But basically, you just pull off a piece that you want to use. You stick it onto the end of whatever blast effect you want to use. And then you would just take your figure, of course, again, you want to use, and you just stick that on the end. You know, it's somewhat successful. I would imagine it'd even be more successful if you use the wax that was provided with this or that the company's also producing. But it gives you a somewhat realistic look if you are one that, again, likes a gorier looking diorama. This fits the bill rather nicely. And again, you can rinse and repeat. You just want, you know, you want to add, like, say, for example, the only problem of using this a couple of times is that it starts to lose its adhesiveness. But basically, if you just want to take yourself, you know, let's grab another piece. While Jason's sort of sitting there wondering why he's been shot, we'll just grab ourselves another piece, though, of the sticky tack. I got myself like a whole roll of this. I can't even remember what I paid for it. Probably like $10 or so on Amazon. Probably was even less than that. But you basically just take your pieces. One thing I do really like about using clear is, even though I've used too much, admittingly, that's way too much than I really needed. If I used a smaller piece, obviously the illusion of this looking like just a gorier exit wound would look a little more believable. But again, like you would just rinse and repeat, you'd add the effects there on the shoulders, for example. You could put it on the side of his head, any which way. But again, I mean, when you're looking at them, they sort of have kind of a desired idea that they have to work a certain way, especially these ones. This one, for example, you could kind of have like a wound there across his chest or around his stomach area if he was slashed. You could also do this as well. Not necessarily even looking at the killers either. I mean, if you had, say, for example, people sometimes when they customize or they do figure photography, they try to find fodder through other figures or other figure companies that have produced sort of more just citizen characters. You could, hey, have why not? Jason swinging around, say, one of the included machetes, for example. Give the, where's the little effect piece? We'll just take that and slide it onto the blade. So you could give that Jason in one of his hands. And then if you had, say, a citizen or someone running away, a victim of Jason, you have them running away, and then you would just basically add the blast effects, all these gory effects just onto their bodies. So there's fun things that you can do with it. But the question really boils down to, is it worth $34.99? I think from the standpoint, if this was cardboard and the lid as well would be cardboard, I think right there I would have said I probably would have gone more to the $25 price point. I don't think it would have been worth the additional $10 on top of that. Being that this, though, is plastic and that the lid is removable gives you at least already one thing that you can do with it. Some of these don't really work as much for my collection space, but that doesn't necessarily mean that they're not worth picking up. Like, for example, the Riot Shield. I can't even see myself ever really using the Riot Shield. But again, like, I'm more in the collection space of getting horror figures and putting them on display. If you have like Marvel Legends, for example, or if you have like a 6 to 7 inch, even though that's not 6 to 7 inch, if you had a 6 to 7 inch scale action figure line that were like police officers or guards, for example, you could use something like this. Things like, for example, the crossbow never would be something I would ever really use. Maybe the axe, I might maybe decide to display one of my figures with the axes, but like some of the accessories are pick and choose. Boxing gloves, I would never really end up seeing myself using them. I think more the mileage for me, at least, and again, only from the standpoint of this person, a collector, is things like the chainsaw. I could see myself using the chainsaw, even if not for Ash. I could probably use it for another character. I could even then swap it out for like the buzzsaw blade. I could use the nail gun for sure. I think that's one of the better looking accessories. And I do like the idea that they gave you slash effects and all these blast effects. Some of them don't work as well. Some of them really need to use a stronger adhesive, just because like these larger ones, for example, they fall off way too frequently unless you have a stronger adhesive sticking them onto the character's body. Or hey, why not? You could also really have Jason lying down, for example, being shot up by someone above him. I mean, the sky's the limit. It really is only boiling down to your personal preference and your creativity when it comes to displaying these. I mean, even though it's a little sick of a thought, you can also have even E.T. barfing up blood. Again, it's only really up to how you like to display your figures. If you are a figure photographer or you're just like one that likes to have very elaborate looking displays, it's a nice set. I think for $35, I would probably have maybe marked it down more to a $30 price point, but at least it does come with a plastic Casket. That's kind of hard to put those two words together. Like I said, I did get this set over on Entertainment Earth. So if you guys are interested to get this for yourself, it is available as of right now. I think it is still available. This also, again, has 26 gruesome accessories, 11 weapons. And again, you've got some gore effects added in there as well. So I think there's mileage to be made. I think honestly, I think they may have beefed up some of the set to ask maybe for the asking price of what they were selling it for by throwing in maybe things again that I don't think rightfully belong necessarily to the Casket of Cruelty. The SWAT shield, I don't think is really one. I mean, yeah, maybe you could probably get a little bit more out of the idea of using the cricket bat. Some of them I would never ever really use, but what I would end up definitely using though is all these gore effects. I think that's a nice little way of beefing up the way you're displaying your figures currently. Have you picked up though the Casket of Cruelty? Let me know down below in the comment section, and have you been using it displaying with your figures? This isn't, by the way, the only thing that Super Action Stuff has been doing. They've also produced a couple of other add-on accessory sets. One that I'm kind of really interested in getting is like the ammunition set. I don't know if that's the actual term for it, but it has basically all the firing bullets. It has all the things that go along with bullets. I think that would be a nice set to get. But being a big horror fan, I had to start things first with the Casket of Cruelty. This is an indeed dark way of wrapping up a review. Jason emerging from his casket dwellings only to be slashed away by his severed hand, Ash Williams. Well, apparently E.T.'s given up all hopes of returning home and just decided instead to barf up blood. Now, these are only just the figures I chose for wrapping up the review. I can't even look at this and take this seriously. This is what I decided to use, at least for the figure examples I had. I mean, obviously I could have brought in other figures like Marvel Legends, for example. Marvel Legends being of that 6 to 7 inch scale. If you did want a more gorier action scene between like the heroes and the villains, obviously a set like this may make to a more darker display, but a fun way to also accent and just kind of bring more to the table than just having your figures displayed on their own. Some figures work a little bit better than others. I mean, looking at this, I never would really display E.T. on my shelf doing this, but it was really the shortest figure I could find, because if not for that, I mean, the blood splatter of having the blood coming out of the mouth would just not have worked unless I had the knees bent on a figure. E.T. just, unfortunately, just through the virtue of being the shortest one I have in my collection, I probably could have done it with Elf too. Just something about Malmakian's barfing up blood. He probably should have stayed away from eating cats. Again, if you guys are interested to get this one for yourself, as far as I know, it's still available over on Entertainment Earth. The Casket of Cruelty will set you back around $34.99 or about $35 all in, plus, of course, all the fun tax that goes along with this. The benefit, at least, though, of going the route of Entertainment Earth is that you can also use the affiliate code I'll put down below in the video description that'll save you at least 10% on not only the Casket of Cruelty, but anything that's currently in stock over on their site. It'll knock 10% off right off the bat. Again, have you guys picked up this for yourself? Let me know down below in the comment section. Or if not, is this something that's enticing enough that you could see yourselves displaying your figures with? If you guys in the meantime did enjoy this video, certainly hit it with a like. If you guys want to stick around for more though, and you haven't already, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below and turn on the bell notification. As always, guys, thanks for watching. See you guys next time.